Did you know that since 2008, more people live in urban than rural areas? Today, 53% of the world population lives in cities, and this will grow to 66% by 2050. So cities are central to our lives. They provide exciting opportunities to the residents, but they also present challenges. Today, we are going to discuss Sustainable Development Goal 11, or SDG 11, which intends to make cities and human settlements inclusive, safe, resilient, and sustainable. This goal is informally called the Urban SDG. It is the only one dealing explicitly with urban areas, and it is the first time there is an urban goal. This reflects the central role cities have acquired for human development. Why are urban areas important? Cities work as magnets for people who move there from rural areas to achieve better living conditions. Cities are places where there is proximity of people, diversity, and multiculturalism. The melting pot metaphor is a central characteristic of the city that becomes very relevant today in relation to the debate on international migration and refugees. For example, Brisbane, Australia, a city with 2 million residents, has citizens born in more than 200 countries. The more diverse, the richer a city is. Cities also attract investment and economic development and are places for consumption. There is proximity and better access to services and infrastructure than in rural areas. However, stark inequalities can be seen in cities. Some urban areas attract investments, good quality services and infrastructure, and are usually occupied by families with high incomes, whereas other areas have a poor provision of services and facilities and are therefore occupied by low-income groups. For example, in Jakarta, Indonesia, every year there are new gated housing developments for upper-class residents, and at the same time, 25% of the population still lives in slums. The SDG 11 refers to cities and human settlements of all sizes. What does it mean for cities and human settlements to be inclusive, safe, resilient, and sustainable? These are very ambitious conditions, and we can't discuss them in full here. However, it is important to think about the opportunities behind this goal and how these four conditions are not isolated but connected. They all contribute to two final objectives: to improve the living conditions of human beings worldwide regardless of social, ethnic, religious, political, and economic differences, and to encourage sustainable urban development worldwide. The first condition of this SDG is inclusive. It refers to leave no one behind, which is one of the main principles supporting the overall definitions of the SDGs. In relation to cities, inclusive refers to inclusive urbanization, which comprises three main aspects. The first one is to provide all stakeholders involved in the production of urban space the opportunity to participate in decision-making processes, and in particular, to give a stronger voice to marginalized groups like slum dwellers and minorities. Second, to guarantee human rights, and in particular, the right to the city. And third, to eliminate exclusion resulting from the competition and unequal investment in urban areas and the informality of jobs and housing conditions. Safe settlements, the second condition of the SDG 11, implies that the residents don't feel in danger, under threat, or in fear because of crime, armed conflicts, and natural disasters. Safety is required for the livability and prosperity of cities. Religious and political conflicts force people to abandon their homes and cities seeking safety. We have seen the impact of the war in Syria, with nearly 5 million of Syrian people seeking refuge in other countries, and about 7 million people being internally displaced, according to the UN. Natural disasters also contribute to people feeling unsafe and having to leave their homes and cities. Safety is linked to resilience, which is the third condition of this SDG. Cities are highly vulnerable to natural disasters, and in particular, earthquakes and flooding. Urban resilience is the capacity of individuals, communities, institutions, businesses, and systems within a city to survive, adapt, and grow, no matter what kind of chronic stresses and acute shocks they experience. Local governments and communities have made significant improvements in developing strategies for disaster and risk reduction over the last years. For example, in Yogyakarta, Indonesia, the local government has implemented a program called Resilient Kampung in 75 kampung or urban settlements. Finally, the fourth condition of SDG 11 is sustainability. The meaning of sustainability in this goal is related to the environment and the efficient use of natural and economic resources, considering our future generations. So how can we achieve SDG 11? The New Urban Agenda, which is a document approved in the Habitat 3 conference in Quito, Ecuador in October 2016, gives some recommendations on this. In addition to the conventional goals of poverty eradication and respect of human rights, the New Urban Agenda includes important points. For inclusive cities, it makes explicit the need to improve the living conditions of homeless people, to recognize the plurality of land tenure types, and to recognize the contribution of the urban poor to the urban economies. And in relation to resilience, there is an emphasis on more proactive responses to disasters and the need to protect food systems in medium and small cities. The New Urban Agenda highlights the critical role of urban planning for implementing SDG 11. Planning systems need to reflect the values supported by the SDGs: universality, leaving no one behind, participation, non-discrimination, transparency, and accountability. These values demand a highly democratic and collaborative planning system involving all actors that produce our cities. This might require changes in planning systems. The SDG 11 is a very ambitious goal because of the extensive meaning of each of the four conditions. But it is possible to make it a reality by 2030 if two elements are considered. We need strong political commitment from national and local governments leading the process. We also need good and meaningful collaborations, including all stakeholders, especially vulnerable groups. We can all contribute to make cities inclusive, safe, resilient, and sustainable, and to achieve real urban sustainable development.